We've touched on how using a custom RTMP middleman server can open a new world of possibilities for your streaming empire. But finally, a new service has finally begun to work with OBS that is actually a lot better in some ways, a lot easier to use, and with more uses for it in the first place. That is NDI. NDI is a video transmission technology that has been in development by NewTek, the company that makes those awesome TriCaster streaming machines and has been really pushing innovation on the broadcasting front. Well, someone by the handle of Palakis has developed a great NDI integration plugin for OBS Studio, and now we can take advantage of this awesome technology within OBS. I'm Evils Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I've got a crapload of these videos at this point in the course playlist, link in the video description. This has hopefully all the answers to any questions you may have, so do check that if you have any questions, and we have plenty of topics covered, and there's an intro video explaining this whole course and how it works in case you get confused. The OBS NDI plugin lets you do three main objectives currently. Add NDI sources from your network into OBS Studio, like any other source. Output your main program view as NDI over your network, and then a special filter that will send a single source from your OBS canvas over NDI. These are all great features, and we'll cover them here. NDI itself can be used in a number of ways for game streaming. Firstly, you can send a video source from one computer, hooked up via USB or capture device, over the local network, across virtually any distance, to your main streaming setup. This is useful for streaming from multiple sets, different gaming stations, having multiple game computers streaming together at once, and so on. NewTek also recently released their Spark dedicated NDI broadcast box for this kind of purpose, or there's a third-party encoder from Bird Dog available as well. These are quite pricey, however, and geared more towards big events. NDI can also be used to optimize PC streaming via a secondary streaming PC without the need for the hassles of a capture card setup. This is perfect for those who run high refresh rate or high resolution monitors that don't play well with capture cards. High refresh rate setups like 120Hz or 144Hz do not like cloning to a 60Hz capture card, and even if they do, you'll get a lot of vertical tearing that way, and the end result may not look great for your viewer. This isn't a problem for NDI-based streaming. NDI uses very little CPU usage and runs across the network at a very low latency, almost real time, to your receiving node or streaming machine. This is a big advantage over RTMP, which can have big delays for it and is fairly difficult to set up. RTMP's delay is fairly significant and can actually vary over time, though it's usually around 2 to 3 seconds, which is very frustrating for audio syncing. NDI is only a few ms of delay time, about double what the HD60 Pro's input latency is, which means audio syncing is really not an issue. Setting up NDI streaming with this plugin is very straightforward compared to pretty much any RTMP server configuration. No port forwarding or any of that nonsense with NDI either. You will absolutely want your gaming PC and streaming PC on a wired Ethernet network for this to work optimally. Wireless just isn't reliable enough for a great experience, and your router might simply not be fast enough for wireless transfers. You can do it, but it can affect delays, video quality, and so on. Just run a wire. It's worth it, I promise. To set up the NDI plugin, close OBS Studio. Go to the plugin page and click Download Now. This will take you to the GitHub. You will need both the plugin and the NDI 3.0 runtime installers. This page has instructions for Linux and Mac OS, but we'll be showing Windows here. There are two ways to install it on Windows. The easiest is to just scroll to the bottom and find the OBS NDI, currently version 4.1.3, though that may vary, windowsinstaller.exe link, and download and run that. This will copy the plugin files to your OBS Studio installation folder and install the NDI runtime and prompt you to reboot. Reboot, and you're good to go. If you want to do it manually, click to download the NDI 3.0 runtime and download and run the installer. Reboot your computer now. Then download the OBS NDI 4.3 or whatever version Windows.zip file and open with your favorite archive manager such as 7-Zip. Extract those files to the root directory of your OBS Studio installation folder. It should be C program files x86 OBS-Studio. Approve any prompts to modify system files, and then you're good to go. Sending your stream over the network via NDI is extremely easy. Simply click Tools, NDI output settings. Here you give your NDI stream a name and click Enable NDI Output and hit OK. Do note that once this is enabled, OBS is technically outputting video, so you won't be able to change your video resolution settings and such like that. Now that you're sending NDI over the network, you can bring it in on a dedicated streaming or capture rig. Add a new source, click NDI source, give it a name. Once the stream has had a minute or two to kick in, this can take a minute in my experience, available NDI streams on your local network will be available via the source name drop-down menu. If you have a high-end PC or have performance issues, you can click Allow Hardware Acceleration to potentially reduce resource usage by the stream. If you have a lot of activity on your network or multiple NDI streams going at once, or you're trying to use wireless, you can check to bring the feed in low bandwidth mode. This will reduce the source's resolution and quality, and in worst case scenario can add a bit more delay, though in my basic testing that has not been the case. This was actually super fascinating to play with. Watching the source feed on the main PC next to the received NDI feed on another PC, there are only a few frames of delay. So crazy. Running a full screen YouTube video through the feed at 1080p used up about 160 megabits or so of transfer speed, though that can obviously change depending on your sources. And again, it was super low latency and very little CPU usage. Using NDI output only added at most 5% more CPU usage compared to just sitting at idle. Insane. Using the primary NDI output tool, it will output the active scene and audio mix, just like a normal stream to Twitch or what have you. This audio shows up just fine and fully in sync on the receiving PC, though you will need to do the mixing on the client side, on this actual gaming PC. Or if you have your audio hardware hooked up to your secondary streaming PC, you can sync it up that way. You may need to add a delay to sync up the audio and video by a few frames. Alternatively, you can just send a single source over NDI to be recorded or streamed elsewhere. This is how the NDI filter works. However, I will say that this part of the plugin has not been super stable for me. Even just trying to test it, the filter would wind up crashing my OBS quite a bit, and I never really got it working the best, but others said it's working just fine. At the same time, I don't really see quite as much use for it, so it's not a big deal in my opinion, but your results may vary. To use this, right-click a source in your scene, keeping in mind that this is directly on a per-source level, not a scene level or anything like that, and click Filters. Add a new effect filter and click Dedicated NDI Output. There are no options for this, it just starts going. Then you just add it as an NDI source like before on the second PC. Again, personally, I've had a lot of trouble getting this to work or even show up on the receiving PC at all, but for some it works just fine. And here's the catch you've been waiting for. Oh, wait, there isn't one. Yeah, that's really it. It's really that simple. No capture card streaming and capture at very high quality with minimal latency and super simple setup. Especially in the higher level broadcasting world, NDI basically feels like magic. Try it for yourself. There's lots of neat uses for it. This is how I'm going to start being able to stream from my retro gaming setup as well. I just wish the dedicated encoding boxes didn't cost quite so much. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it has, hit the like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech and educational content. If you like game streaming, come follow me on Twitch and drop me a message in chat. I'm Ablesvox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.